Memories are so important to us. They define who we are. They help shape our lives and comfort us when we grow old. This is for you, Mum. A way to hold on to your memories. You grew up in such a big family. Teresa Mitzi, one of 13 children, 8 girls and 5 boys. When you took us to Malta and I saw the house you grew up in, it seemed so big, but not nearly big enough for 13 kids. I remember as a child of 7 or 8 asking you what life was like when you were my age. It amazed us as kids hearing stories of you and Dad as young children growing up during World War II. The times you had to take refuge in bomb shelters. But despite the turmoil going on around you, most of the memories we shared were of happy times with lots of brothers and sisters around. As a young woman living in the town of Leah, a handsome man entered your life while strolling in a public garden. That's how you met people in those days. You strolled down to the park with friends. Eugene courted you for 9 months before announcing he was heading to Australia, a little known land on the other side of the world, a place to start a new life in a land of opportunity. So he sailed away, leaving his sweetheart back at home. 4.5 long years he was gone, the only contact were those weekly letters of love. I can remember looking at the photos of you before getting married and thinking you were the most beautiful woman I've ever seen. I guess that's the person Dad first fell in love with. Despite the distance, love never failed. Somehow, Dad convinced you to become his wife. He returned to Malta in November 1960 and tied the knot. You guys were trendsetters back in those days, the first assisted immigrants to fly to Australia. 10-pound migrants, they called you. A ticket to a new life together so far away from home, friends and family. It wasn't long before more family members came over and a little house in Berry Street, Coburg became something of a halfway home, a stopover for others looking to begin a new life in Melbourne, Australia. In 1961, my big brother John was born. When I look at the old photos and Super 8 film, these looked like really happy times. All my aunties and uncles looked so young, probably the same age I am now. Young families growing together.
Pussycat, I've got flowers and lots of hours to spend with you.
6 years later, I arrived along with Paul, the terrible twins. The family doubled overnight, and what a workload it must have been. During the early 70s, you tried for another child. James was born, but he wasn't with us long, only a few short hours. In 1972, Jason came along, the fourth and final boy for you, Mum and Dad. Jason has special needs and holds a very unique place in the lives of you and Dad and all the family. It must have been hard keeping 4 rowdy boys in line. You both kept up a united front when it came to discipline. That line, just wait till your father gets home, was used quite a few times. But sometimes, if we were really bad, immediate action was needed, and that's when the slipper came off. We all thought you were a bad shot, but I suspect you deliberately aimed short of the mark. Right from the start, you both must have known only hard work was going to get the home that you wanted for all of us to grow up in. As if having 4 boys wasn't enough, you also worked cleaning offices in the evening. You left for work after keeping house during the day, and only after making sure we all had a cooked dinner on the table. Sometimes we were even in bed before you came home. Over the years, our family here grew. 2 sons were married, and suddenly you had to come to terms with being a grandmother, none the Tess. Life hasn't always been easy, has it, Mum? Most of your family is still in Malta. You've returned to the small island in the middle of the Mediterranean twice in the last 4 decades, but home is now Australia, the place you have lived most of your life, the place where you began your own family, caring for us boys, devoted to your loving husband and family, always putting us first. So now it's our turn to look after you. You have shared so many memories with us. Mum, these memories are for you.
Cheers.
Well, she's all you'd ever want. She's the kind I'd like to flaunt and take to dinner. But she always knows her place. She's got style, she's got grace. She's a winner. She's a lady. Oh, 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 she's a lady. Talking about